if we don't pass the torch to the next generation, everything that we've fought for will pass away.
If we don't have people who believe the principles of freedom, we won't be a free nation.
The only way you can be a free nation is if you have a citizenry that's educated well enough to understand what it takes to preserve freedom.
It is so important that the next generation of young people be ready and prepared to fight for freedom.
Good future leadership happens intentionally.
And that's what Gen J is all about, to make sure that people understand the principles of freedom and will be willing to lead the country toward freedom in the years ahead.
This idea of freedom is the most important thing that we have, and it's worth fighting for.
I don't want to be someone who grows old watching the sunset of America and telling my son stories about it, what it used to be.
Our country's future is at stake.
If Christians cease to be involved, we'll lose the foundation that made America great. America is great because America is good.
We need some young people who will stand up, who will believe in freedom, and really understand the God-given foundation this nation is built upon.
Stand up for what is right. Don't give up. Every single person has a sphere of influence, and God has put you into that place to make a difference.
On a hill far away, stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. For I love that old cross, where the dearest and best, for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I cherish the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I laid down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To that old rugged cross I will ever be true. It's shame and reproach gladly bear, till he calls me someday to my home.
Cast off the robes you're wearing, set aside the names that you've been given. May this place of rest in the fold of your journey bind you to hope. You will never walk alone
in the shadows.
Yours are the eyes to look complete.
passionately to bless you and me, bless you and me. He will bless you and me. Go into the world showing how much He loves you. Walk in the world, meaningful ways. He loves you. He loves you. Emmanuel on earth. God with us on earth. Yours is the body, hands and the feet, and yours are the eyes to look compassionately, to bless you and me, bless you and me. He will bless you and me, to bless you and me, bless you and me.
Love has to follow. Practical action of love has to follow. 실천되는 사랑이 이제 보여야 됩니다. 이 가슴에, 그렇죠. 머리에서 이해하고 가슴에서 뜨거워지는 게 실천이 돼야 되죠. Three H's, it's very important. When you understand the truth of God's word, it always has to register up your head. It has to go from head, three H, the head to the heart to the hand. Head to the heart, to the hand. Look what the Bible says. What good is it? James 2:14 says, what good is it, my brother, if a man claims to have faith but has no deeds? 내 형제들아, 만일 사람이 믿음이 있노라 하고 행함이 없으면 무슨 이익이 있으리요? 이게 뭐야, 이게? 오늘날로 말하면 이게 뭐야? 하나님이 그러실 거예요. 이게 뭐야, 이게? 아니, 이게 뭐야, 형제들아, 사람이 믿음이 있노라 하고, 사랑이 있노라 하고, 행함이 없으면 이게 뭐야, 이게? 이게 뭡니까? 그거 이게 뭡니까? What is this? If you claim to have faith and love and there's no deeds, what is that? What is that? I want to show you a church that's nearby, Buena Park Baptist Church, that for 23 years has consistently ministered to the weak, the poor, and the homeless. This particular church is where our church goes every month to serve, to people who live there in the shelter provided by the church, to cut their hair, to love them, to cook, make food for them. We go there every month, our church does. It's a beautiful story of how one church decided, okay, what we understand up here, what is burning in my heart here, we're going to put it into action. Buena Park Baptist Church에 우리 교회에서 매달 가는 곳인데, 우리 국내 선교팀에서 가서 매달 그곳에 계시는 shelter에 있는 분들 머리를 잘라주고 옷을 입혀드리고 음식을 해드리고, 이 교회가 여기서 얼마 안 돼요. 이 교회가 참 그 지난 23년 동안 우리 주변에 있는 교회인데 얼마나 그 예수님의 사랑을 가지고 액션, 디드를 하고 있는가 잠시 좀 보시길 바라요. Look at this church and be inspired.
On Wednesday, February 4th at 2:30 in the afternoon, we visited the First Southern Baptist Church of Buena Park. This church runs a homeless shelter. This homeless shelter is one of six total homeless shelters in the entire Orange County area. And it is one that Sarang Community Church has been helping for the last 6 years. The senior pastor of the church, Pastor Wiley S. Drake, is also the caretaker of the shelter.
I came here in 1987 as pastor of this church. That was a little over 20 years ago. And after I had been here about 3 years, brought to my attention that we needed to help the poor and the homeless in the community. And for the first 3 years, we did very little. And then in 1990, we started doing clothes and food and just started small and then grew it to where it's at today.
Pastor Drake showed us around the church facility. The first thing they do for a homeless person is to set up a phone line and a mailbox.
Well, if they don't have a place to sleep and they don't have a phone number and they don't have a place to take a shower, they can't get a job. Let's say a guy by the name of Smith, you know, he comes, his mail being the S. Now he has a mailing address. Now he can fill out an application for employment if he has a mailing address. He also has a telephone number here. Now he has a telephone number. And that's the first way we help them.
The homeless population in general in Orange County, about 30,000 homeless.
The sweet aroma of a home-cooked meal catches our attention.
This is the kitchen area. Of course, our refrigerators. And this is Brenda.
Hi, how are you?
She's our cook. She's getting ready for tonight's meal.
Volunteers are preparing meals for the homeless. Most of the volunteers are homeless themselves.
We were living homeless in our car, and we came here for a place to stay, and Pastor opened his doors to us.
The pantry is filled with food donated by different groups, organizations, and individuals.
All of these cookies and bread are donated to us by grocery stores and bakeries and all kinds of places.
Pastor Drake emphasizes the crucial necessity of the spiritual need as well as the physical need of a person.
Just shelter somebody does not have the same effect as if you have shelter plus counseling. So that's definitely a need, I think, where a church can be involved in.
Across from the kitchen is the dormitory. The dormitory can hold about 55 people.
So this is the ladies' side, and the other side is the men's side. And this, we have about 55 beds in here. Single beds, double beds, about 55 altogether.
It's not what one can normally call a home, but it is a warm shelter for those in need. With round-the-clock security, it is very safe, and strict rules are enforced.
Everybody here, we normally would give 30 days opportunity to find them a job. We don't care if they have other religions that they worship or other things that they worship. When they're here on our time, they have to give our God his time.
Arise from a Catholic food bank.
Thank you very much for bringing the food. We appreciate it. As I was saying, it's a perfect example. We're Baptist. Sarong Church is a Presbyterian church, and Second Harvest is Roman Catholic background. So here's an example of three denominations
coming together.
Helping those in need crosses all denominational lines and barriers.
There's maybe 10,000 pounds right here. I mean, it's quite a bit.
So you do thousands of pounds typically every day.
170 people every day. Consistent, continual outside help is absolute. A man who heartily greets Pastor Drake is none other than Tony Samiago, who claims to have fought in the Korean War in 1950.
Yes, I was in Korea in 1950. Wow. Yeah, I went to service in 1948. I was 18 years old. I was a jump master. And then from there I went to Korea and with my men. And I was fortunate to come back alive, but it took me a lot of years to get over the deaths of my men.
When we looked at Tony, who risked his life for Korea, we realized that this is a way to repay for what he and others have done for us. It's just past 5 o'clock, but there is already a long line of people waiting to get food. Mr. David Gonzalez has been helping the homeless in this shelter.
I enjoy this a lot. And this is just an all-out good place to be. Like, the people here are kind.
I love everybody here, and they're courteous and just beautiful, beautiful people, and the services are great.
From 7 o'clock in the morning to 5 in the evening, people constantly serve out food for all 7 days of the week. Love and care seem to be the only way for broken souls to be lifted up.
You can't truly affect the quality of life just flying in, flying out. There's more of a consistency and a commitment that must be made.
You know, till Jesus comes, we believe the Bible makes it very clear, inasmuch as you've not done it unto one of the least of these, my brethren, you've not done it unto me. So we're doing this for Jesus, we're doing it to Jesus, and we're doing it because the need is so great until we go to heaven. That's right.
He is living out Christ's command to Christians to love our neighbors as ourselves. In these tough economic times, just as Christ Jesus has done in his earthly ministry, we wish to continue his ministry of love and hope for the broken and the lost.
Can a nation be saved? Can a nation be turned back to you?
Did you know an 8-year-old boy couldn't pass out candy at Christmas because they had Jesus printed on the wrapper?
A federal appeals court upheld that roadside crosses are unconstitutional.
A pastor was ordered to stop holding Bible studies in the privacy of his own home.
A nurse was forced to participate in a late-term abortion, even though she had a written agreement that her religious convictions would be honored.
A Baton Rouge church was ordered to stop feeding homeless victims of Hurricane Katrina because they offered voluntary prayer and Bible study.
A photographer was ordered to pay nearly $7,000 after she declined to photograph a couple's same-sex marriage.
Judges have literally turned the original meaning of the First Amendment upside down. Our Constitution protects and celebrates religious liberty. It does not censor or prohibit it. A quote attributed to Patrick Henry states that the Constitution is not an instrument for the government to restrain the people. It is an instrument for the people to restrain the government, lest it come to dominate our lives and our interests, end quote. Isn't it time we go back to the Constitution?
We have to be vigilant over our government. Government behaves a lot better when they know people are watching.
We, the United States, has got to raise up political leaders who will tell us the truth about the difficult decisions we're going to have to make, and we're going to have to be willing to follow the suggestions and support and elect those people.
Religious liberty is gravely threatened in America, the gravest threat it's had since the founding of this republic.
Our ability to shape our culture and our future flows from what our founders called our first freedom. How can we stop these kind of abuses? Well, elected representatives write our laws. Federal judges, appointed by the president, rule on those laws. If we want a different future, we must elect men and women who pledge to defend the original intent of the Constitution. If you value freedom and want to preserve that blessing for your children and grandchildren, get informed. Go to the polls and vote your values, your biblical values, and make a difference.
I'm only one person.
One voice.
One vote.
I can't do everything.
But I can do something.
I can register.
I can cast my vote.
And I can make a difference. I will. Will you?
I will. Will you?
I will. Will you?
I will. Will you?
This morning, I had another talk with the German Chancellor, Herr Hitler. And here is the paper which bears his name upon it as well as mine. We regard the agreement signed last night as symbolic of the desire of our two peoples never to go to war with one another again.
When Hitler rose to power, no one believed that he would actually do the things that he said.
history teaches us something very simple. When an enemy says he's going to annihilate you, believe him.
Iran today poses a danger that threatens to engulf the entire world in chaos.
A nuclear armed Iran is a grave danger to the peace and security of the entire world.
Diplomacy has failed.
Will sanctions work?
If diplomacy doesn't work, the clock could run out. We've wasted years on failed diplomacy. There's no chance Iran will be talked out of its nuclear weapons program.
Iran is believed to be expanding right now its uranium enrichment activity deep inside of a mountain bunker.
Iran has tripled the pace of production of 20% grade uranium. They're transferring their facilities underground to be immune.
Time is running out.
They're racing towards acquiring a nuclear weapon.
None of us can afford to wait much longer.
وأن تكون قنبلة ذرية إيران وباكستان قنابل ضد إسرائيل ونهتف كما هتفنا في طهران مار جبار إسرائيل مار جبار أمريكا.
For the sake of our prosperity, for the sake of our security, for the sake of our children, Iran must
stop.
Be
Iran.
Stop
now. Last time, the world was silent. This time, our voices will be heard.
I remember when Tony Perkins first felt the heart of God to call pastors to have a corporate time of prayer for the nation every year. The call to fall was born out of a leader's heart for the nation and the understanding that pastors and their churches can be positive gatekeepers for America.
I believe that prayer is essential and fundamental for our success in being involved in whatever happens in government and politics. And the reason why is because prayer, if you look at the believers in the New Testament, prayer was to enable them to receive power and anointing so they could be effective. We cannot be effective without God. We need the Lord to empower us, to give us boldness, to give us confidence, to break the fear out of our lives so we could go forth and be the world changers.
I believe prayer is our only hope. I believe that praying for God to forgive us and to give us another chance as a nation is the place where we are right now. And if we don't get that, we don't have any place to go.
And the last several years, we have partnered with the Family Research Council and taken part in the Call to Fall. In fact, last year, after the Call to Fall event, I had people come up to me saying, can we do this every Sunday? They were so excited about being able to come and pray for America. So we actually have our worship team that's there. They will play. Someone will grab the microphone and pray. They'll break out into a song. Somebody else will pray. They'll lead us in another chorus of worship. So it's this atmosphere, not only of prayer and intercession, but of worship to God. And then it just sets the stage for Sunday's worship time.
The Sunday before Independence Day, we're asking that you spend at least a few minutes on your knees as a church praying for America. Visit calltofall.org to join what is becoming a movement with churches participating in all 50 states. Who knows but what God might hear our cries, forgive our sins, and heal our land.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to CrusadeRadio.com, and also welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. And we thank you so much for being here with us. And we thank you and want to remind you that if you'd like to be on the show with us, this is sort of casual Monday. I didn't put my coat back on, but we welcome you to the Wiley Drake Show. If you'd like to call us, you can do so by simply going to the phone and calling us on 5961. 559-592-5961. And give us a call, and we'd love to have you come online with us. And there's also another number. You can call us on the 800 number. 1-800-839. Thank you. 1-800-839-3002. And we welcome you to the Wiley Drake Show on the 800 number, or however you would call us. 559-592-5961 or the 800 number. If you want to get us on the 800 number, we would appreciate you doing that just as well. So may God bless you. May God give you a great, great day. And we do thank you so much for being a part of the Wiley Drake Show here on CrusadeRadio.com. I'm going to see if I can pull up Crusade Radio, but I've got to put them in a little bit different than normal. But www.crusaderadio.com, CrusadeRadio.com, and we'll try to pull them up there with that. We thank the Lord for you being here with us, ladies and gentlemen. And we got to open that in a new tab. Open this up in a... well, we're going to close this one. But we're going to have to open this up in a new tab here so that we can get Crusade Radio up here for us in just a moment. And we're going to delete that and then put in HTTP and... hit enter, and hopefully that will bring us up to Crusade Radio and get us live here on the air in just a moment. We do thank you for listening. We do thank you for being a part of the show. We're going to have some callers today. One of our callers is going to be from our folks on the road, and we praise the Lord for that, and we hope that they do join us. I'm going to be looking at the schedule. We're going to have Christina Garza. We're hoping Christina Garza is going to be with us. And
that he has done this.
Now, we do have Crusade Radio up, but I'm not on. Somebody else is, and I'm not sure what's going on there.
You only go to heaven one way.
But, Brother Mel, I'm here. We're here. Crusade Radio is idle. No, it's not. H-E-L-L-O, I'm going to say hello, and hopefully we'll get in there to Brother Mel. And if not, I'll call Ms. Mel. I know how to get him on the ball. We'll call Miss Mel. And anyway, thank you so much for listening today, and thank you for being a part of the Wiley Drake Show. And we thank you.
A true church.
And we're going to see if we can roust Mr. Mel. And see if we can, no, I don't want Tony. Tony called, by the way, folks, for those of you who've been praying for Tony, he is still in intensive care, and we do want you to continue to pray for him. He is still in intensive care. He's had a couple of heart attacks, and we're praying for him, but he sounded much better this afternoon than he has in a while, and so we thank the Lord that he is doing some better. And praise the Lord.
Salvation.
And we do have another preacher on the line, and that's okay. He's preaching about salvation. That's very, very important. We would encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, give us a call, 1-800-839-3002, and we would welcome you to give us a call. Line 2 is open, and we thank the Lord for it. Mel, we've got somebody else on the line, so if you could clear Crusade Radio for me, I'd appreciate it. God bless you. Have a great day. All right, we call Ms. Mel, and hopefully she'll get the word to him. And in the meantime, we want to talk to you about several things. Number one, there is a special event going on tomorrow. We hope to be a part of it. This is from our good friend up in D.C. Jason Hershey with YWAM. And Ryan Montgomery put this out, and it says, "Dear friends, our regional pre-rally for David's Tent is tomorrow night." Now, ladies and gentlemen, that's on Tuesday night. And we want all of you to come join us as we worship and pray, and they will be worshiping and praying, and prepare the ground in the spirit for what begins September the 25th. Jason Hershey will also be sharing a short word on the vision for David's Tent and some of the prophetic history leading up to this point. It's going to be an amazing evening, uniting together from across the region, and we hope across the nation and literally around the world. I hope if you're anywhere near Washington, D.C., you'll make your way. You'll make your way there and be a part. If you cannot be there, we're going to be doing a special early live broadcast. We're going to be doing a special prayer meeting. We will have a special prayer meeting at 4 o'clock tomorrow, 4 o'clock California time. That will be 7 o'clock in Washington, D.C. And we're hoping that we can reach somebody there. If not, that's okay. We can pray with them and for them, even if we're not there. And so tomorrow at 4 p.m. on Tuesday afternoon, we will have a special David's Tent prayer. They're going to be worshiping and praying and preparing the ground. There's been a permit that's been issued by the Capitol Hill Police Department or whoever it is that issues permits. And it's there on the ellipse. That is one of the parts of the grounds of the White House. It's part of the lawn of the White House. And they have applied for and received a permit to have a 40-day prayer and worship meeting there near the White House, an oval office, an oval altar for the Oval Office. And so we do encourage you to go with us to Washington, D.C. David's Tent, it will be set up, and it will be opened on the 25th, which is the last Tuesday in the month. That will be September the 25th when David's Tent is opened. And we would welcome you to go there and be a part of that. We'll be doing a live broadcast from there. We're going to be doing a lot of live broadcasts this month from different venues, different operations. We're hoping to have a call here in the very near future this afternoon from Christina Garza, who is a worker, an employee, if you will, for the organization called Survivors. Christina Garza is the campus outreach director of Survivors of the Holocaust called Abortion. And she'll be on with us, hopefully, in the very near future, by near future in minutes, hopefully. She'll be able to join us. And they're on a trip, and they set out today, I believe, and we'll find out more on that when we talk to Christina. But we do thank them for doing what you're doing. And we're hoping that Brother Mel will listen to his wife and get that other guy off of there and let us go ahead with our show. But if you'd like to be on the show with us, we are broadcasting to you on Ustream.tv. Ustream.tv. Now, we are available, ladies and gentlemen, to do live broadcasts from your location. You just get Jaime and I there. We'll be glad to come and do a live broadcast right from your location, right from your own church, right from your tent, wherever you're at. We'll be doing a live broadcast for wherever your ministry is at. And we thank you for that.
But I
want to read you one here from...
Now, we do thank you for listening. I want to share with you several things that are going on. David's Tent, of course, on the 25th, and you can get in touch with them. And there's also a very, very important thing coming up at 10 a.m. On Saturday. On Saturday at 10 a.m. in Birmingham, which will be 8 a.m. here in California, we'll be doing a live prayer line and a live broadcast for you to pray for Birmingham and pray for what's called the redigging of the wells on September the 15th. Jesus, justice, and a new generation. Justice, mercy, and walking with God. That's what we're going to be praying about and praying and talking about on that date. So we would encourage you to join
us. And you're supposed to believe us now. There's no...
Now, we do thank you for that and do appreciate you being with us and hope that you'll help us and hope you'll pray with us and pray for us. Pray for these different events. We are working also, ask that you'd pray for us. We're working toward trying to put together another event for our veterans on Veterans Day. And ladies and gentlemen, it would be our desire to do that event on Veterans Day at Independence Hall here at Buena Park. And I'm going to be talking, hopefully, this week with Buena Park, this week with those at Independence Hall. But we will have on Veterans Day, ladies and gentlemen, Veterans Day is on the 12th day of November. And on the 12th day of November, we will honor our veterans. Now, I'm hoping that we can do that at Independence Hall. But if we cannot do it at Independence Hall, we will do it right here at the First Southern Baptist Church of Buena Park. So we are going to have a special honoring of the veterans, the second annual honoring of the veterans, will be here in Buena Park. I'm hoping and trusting that God will allow us the privilege to do it at Knott's Berry Farm. And I hope that that'll happen. And if that happens, we'll do it there. If not, we will do it here at the First Southern Baptist Church of Buena Park, California. So we are scheduling, it's already scheduled for November the 12th. November the 12th. That will only be a little more than a week past the election. But we're going to honor our veterans one way or the other. We will either honor them at Independence Hall in Buena Park, or we will honor them here at the First Southern Baptist Church and the headquarters of the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C. The first annual veterans honoring was done at Independence Hall, and I hope that we can do that not only on the second year, but other years. Hello? Do we have a caller on? Okay, I thought we had a caller on there, but I guess we lost him. Yeah, we lost him. We're going to have the beepy, beepy, beepy sound, but that's okay.
Feet high, and on top of that was now about 300 feet in the air stood the statue of a Babylonian.
That will go away shortly. Brother Mel is not in the studio, and when he does not hang the phone up, the machine does it automatically, but not nearly as efficiently and nearly as quickly as Mel does. That's why you had that beeping tone there for a while, because it takes a machine about 20 seconds Brother Mel's a lot quicker than that. He can do it a lot quicker than that. And we are going to hopefully get another caller here from Christina Garza. I don't know whether she called the other number or not. I don't know if that was her. We'll wait and see if the 800 number is called. And if not, we will call her with the 800 number. So we're going to give her a few minutes. And if that doesn't work, we'll call her. We'll try her. So we're hoping that we can get her. We're going to see if we can raise her right now. Hello, Christina.
Hi, Pastor Wiley.
Hey, how are you? Did you try on the other line?
No, I was just about to.
Oh, okay, that's okay. Well, we got you on the line. We had another caller, and it was a female, and the call got dropped, and I was afraid it might have been you.
That's a coincidence. I was just about to call.
Okay, that's fine. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have on the line with me, welcome, Christina Garza. She is the campus outreach director for an organization here on the West Coast and around the nation, and that is Survivors of the American Holocaust, the abortion. And so we welcome her and like for you to indeed share with us, if you would, Christina, a little bit about what's going on, a little bit about Survivors, where you're at, where you're headed, and so forth.
Well, Survivors of the Abortion Holocaust is a pro-life youth activist ministry. And so our target audience are high school and college-age youth. And we have essentially three main parts of the ministry. First, we host a pro-life training camp every summer for young people to be trained to become activists and leaders. Pro-life movement and become a new activism in LA. And then we have our International Pro-Life Youth Conference. This year it's going to be November 10th, 11th, and 12th, where, again, we train young people, but it's a shorter form of training than camp, and we have pro-life leaders from all over the nation come speak. So we had Jill Stanek last year. We're going to have Father Pavone this year, and Ryan Baumberger from the Radiant Foundation. And then the third branch of the organization is Campus Life Force. And, right now I'm actually in the van with the Campus Life team, with a team of missionaries handpicked by survivors to travel the nation to proclaim the truth about abortion on college and high school campuses. And so we change the mindset of our generation one person at a time, going after one heart at a time, one soul at a time, encouraging young people to be pro-life, but also to, this year especially, to vote pro-life. And that leads into where we're headed right now. We are actually on our way to Albuquerque, which will be our first stop on our cross-country tour, but our destination is Washington, D.C. On September 29th, we will begin 72 hours of prayer in front of the White House, prayer, prophetic witness, and even risking arrest in front of the White House, in direct opposition to the Health and Human Services mandate within the Affordable Care Act, also known as Obamacare. And we are calling young people to join us as we stand up for our faith, because we know that the HHS mandate is an overt attack on faith and on people of faith and on religious freedom. So we are going to stand for our religious freedom September 29th through October 2nd during an event titled Act 529.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we want you to know that we are supportive of these young people, and we're going to do everything we can to allow them to give us reports from day to day as they make their trip from Albuquerque into Tulsa, Kansas, Dayton, Columbus, Cleveland, Steubenville, and Philadelphia, and then into Washington, D.C., and then to be there for the Acts 529 event there to indeed stand for religious freedom. There will be a rosary held and an evangelical ministry as well. And so we thank you, Christina, for sharing with us. Share with our audience a little bit, if you would. The name of the organization is survivors.la. That's the website. Give us the history of that. Why is it called that?
Well, our name is very forthright. Anybody born after 1973 is a survivor of the American abortion Holocaust. Since the legalization of abortion, or the decriminalization of abortion in the United States, with the Roe v. Wade decision in 1973, over one-third of our generation has been aborted. So that's over 53 million youth, or young people, closer to 55 million babies right now. We kill over 1.3 million babies in the United States every single year. This is a direct assault on our generation. Not only are we marketed for the abortion procedure, but we were targeted for extermination. I know that even on the team right now of these kids that are sitting in the van, there are probably people whose parents were told to have an abortion. I know my mom is one of them. And so we are very literally survivors of the abortion Holocaust in the United States of America. And so we feel that it is our burden and our responsibility to train other people of our generation to engage in the battle against abortion and promote life. And that the only way that this battle against abortion will win is if our generation fights that and claims that victory for ourselves.
Amen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, when you stop and think about it, I obviously was born long before 1973, but one-third of this young lady's generation are in the grave, dead because of the Holocaust in America. One-third of her generation. And that's why they're so strong and standing so strong. And Christina Garza is the campus outreach director for this group of young, battling men and women who are standing, who are willing to stand, and who are going to Washington, D.C. to say, we must obey God rather than men, or a man. We must obey God. And so I want you to pray with them and pray for them. And if you would like to make a donation to support them, to help them in any way with their expenses, please go to survivors.la. There's a spot there where you can donate, and please be a part. Pray with them. Pray for them. If you're watching us on television, you will see those websites up there. And we want to encourage you to call. We want you to encourage you to get online. We want to encourage you to support these young people who are so diligently fighting this fight and fighting this battle for my religious freedom as well as yours. Christina Garza, thank you so much. Please give our love to your friends there on the van, on the bus.
The team could actually say hi for themselves. Everybody, 1, 2, 3. So you'll be hearing from them over the next couple of weeks. We'll share stories from campus ministry. We have really amazing experiences when we are on campus watching people have conversions right on the spot.
Amen. Amen. And we certainly are thankful. And
thank you.
Thank you to all of you on the bus there, on the van. We want you to know we love you. We're praying for you. And we're going to be talking with you on your trip. And then I will have the privilege, take the privilege to come to be with you there in Washington, D.C., to stand with you and to stand even to be arrested if necessary. We'll be there. And we know you're going to be there. And we're praying with you and for you. And
just praise
the Lord for what you're doing. Christina Garza, thank you so much. God bless you. We'll look forward to hearing from you again tomorrow.
Absolutely. Thank you, Pastor Wiley.
God bless you and have a great day.
You too. Bye.
Bye-bye. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was Christina Garza, the campus outreach director. I believe we have another caller on the line now. Caller, are you there?
Yes, Pastor Wiley, thank you. This is Thomasima Pinnell, author to Denton Place Dash Tables Turned.
All right. Tell us one more time your name and what you're the author of.
Thank you. This is Thomasima Pennell, and I am the author to the book titled Benton Place-Tables Turn with Wine Press Publishing.
Well, we have had over the years a great opportunity to work with Wine Press, and they always bring us very good authors and very good presentations. Tell us a little bit about, if they go and get your book, tell them what they can expect to find in your book.
Thank you. You can go to winepresspublishing.com or winepressbooks.com, and what you will expect to see once you get there is a story about who does a woman from a picture-perfect family find herself entangled in a web of deceit and heartache. In the novel Benton Place, Tables Turn, I am the author. What about Julia, a woman whose journey in life takes her through multiple struggles, a wedlock pregnancy, abortion, disability of a child, divorce, revenge. And basically her quest eventually leads her to great sorrow, ultimately peace with the almighty peace, almighty God. While the book is fiction, it is based on experiences of my life story.
Well, we want to encourage all of our listeners, first of all, because of Wine Press, and second of all, because this book sounds very intriguing, sounds like a great book. Did you put out a press release on Christian Newswire?
No, I did not.
Okay, well, that's why I was just wondering where we saw about your book. But we want to say to all of our listening audience, ladies and gentlemen, if you purchase her book and you read her book, we would welcome you to come on the Wiley Drake Show and tell our listening audience what you found in the book and how it blessed you. And if you purchase the book, we'll give you that opportunity. And all you have to do is contact me and we'll have you on the show. We'll book you on the show to give a book report. And so we would encourage you to do that. Now, tell our listening audience one more time the title of the book and where they can find it, as well as with Wine Press.
Thank you. The title of the book is Benton Place-Tables Turned with WinePressBooks.com under Wine Press Publishing. And I am the author, Thomasima Pennell. Thomasima, last name Pennell, Pannell.
Well, Thomasina, thank you so much for being with us today and telling us about this book, and I hope you'll get us a copy so we can read the book and share with our audience. And did my producer give you our address?
No, sir, but I spoke with my publicist, Robin Williams, from Wine Press Publishing. You should have your book by tomorrow.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. And ladies and gentlemen, I want you to get your copy, and I want you to read it, and I want you to contact me. I'm going to give you my phone number, folks. If you want to call me, you can reach me at 714-865-8132 and say, I read Thomasina's book, and I want to talk about it. I want to come on the air and talk about it, and we'll book you on the air to come on the worldwide Wiley Drake Show around the world, and you can tell the world what experience you had with her book. And I promise you a blessing, ladies and gentlemen, based on the intrigue of that title and based on the reputation of Wine Press. We have been working with them for years, and they always bring us excellent, excellent material in these books. And so get the book and read it, and then come on our program and talk to us about it. Thomasina, anything else you'd like to share with our audience?
Yes, Pastor Drake, and thank you again. I want to first personally thank you for giving me the opportunity to share the book as a new release. One of the things I find the most intriguing about the book that I included in there is a section called Talk About These Things and Think of These Things. I personally put that in there because the book is targeted to be a group taught book and a conversational book. Yes, sir.
Well, thank you so much for that. It does sound intriguing. We're looking forward to it. I am. And I know my audience will be too. And as I said, for you audience, you have trusted us over the years. You know that we do not bring you just anything. We don't promote just anything. We only promote those things that we believe will stand for what we stand for. And the theme of this program is do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. And if a book or a record or music or anything does not stand for that, then we do not send it to you, do not even talk about it. And so you know we can be trusted, and we know that Wine Press can be as well. And Thomasina is a great artist, and you're going to be blessed by reading her book. And we want to encourage you. We want to give you a little bit of incentive. If you want to be on the Wiley Drake Show, you're welcome to do so. Simply read the book and call me and say, I read the book and I want to talk about it, and do that. And so we encourage you to do that. Thomasina, thank you so much for being with us today. God bless you and have a great, great evening.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
And God bless you. Bye-bye. All right, ladies and gentlemen, another great book out there, and we encourage you to get your copy and then contact me. Get your copy and then contact me and let me know, and we'll be more than happy to book you on the Wiley Drake Show. We do thank you and want to encourage you to put these prayer points on your prayer list. Tomorrow, the Survivors Group, they're on their way to Albuquerque. They'll be going to Tulsa, Kansas City, Louisville, Kentucky, Dayton, Ohio, and on down the road a ways. Let's see if we can... Good afternoon and welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. Hello? Hello, hello. Well, I believe we lost that caller. Yep. Sorry about that. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're trying to call, if you call in on the cell phone and you get disconnected, there are two other numbers that we would love to have you call in on. One, of course, is our number at Crusade Radio.
You know, and it would be
The one at Crusade Radio is got some other interference right now. So I'm going to give you the 800 number. If you would like, we would encourage you to call us on the 800 number, ladies and gentlemen. Call us on that 800 number and let us know what's on your mind. Thank you so much for being a part. The 800 number is 1-800-839-3002. Let's try this again. Hello, caller. Are you there?
Yes, I am.
All right. Well, who do we have on the line with us? All right. Did you put out a press release on this?
Yes, sir.
Well, hang on just one second. Let me get to Christian Newswire. What's the title of your press release?
It's Benson Place, Tables Turned.
All right. I'm looking for it here, and I'm not seeing it. I'm sorry, but that's okay. Tell us about the book, and tell us about you. Benton Place, all right?
Yes, Benton Place, P-L-A-C-E, uh-huh.
Very good. Tell us, if we purchase your book, first of all, tell us where we can purchase it, and tell us what we're going to find when we read your book.
Okay, well, it's a book that I purchased, and I was, you know, very interested to make sure that if all your listeners are reading it, it's by my girlfriend. She's the author of the book from Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Well, North Carolina is a special place recently, but tell us about the book.
The book, well, actually, it's a bio. My girlfriend, she's just talking about the way she grew up and the different, you know, what she went through. It's a very good read, because what it is, actually, it's her experience, her lessons, her life lessons, and actually it's a healing process for her. While reading the book, you can see the different spaces she went through, and it's a healing process throughout her life. but I can relate to a lot of it. It's a true story that I can relate to it. She has a daughter, and I have a daughter around the same age, and I think, you know, if our kids read it, they won't be able to make the mistake that my girlfriend makes. So it's a learning lesson.
Amen, amen. Well, do you know what the do you know what the title of your press release was?
The title is Denton Place, D-E-N-T-O-N, Place, P-L-A-C-E, Tables Turned.
Okay, very good.
It's a Wine Press publishing.
All right, published by Wine Press, and we thank the Lord for Wine Press. They've done a great job over the years and are continuing to do so.
Yeah, thank you, Lord, for bringing me my girlfriend into my life because, boy, she's been a real blessing to me and my family.
Amen, amen. Well, thank you for sharing with us today. God bless you and have a great evening. Anything else you would like to say to our audience?
Thank you, my girlfriend and her family, Thomasima Parnell from Fayetteville, North Carolina. And everyone, go and purchase the book. You won't regret it. It's a wonderful read. And like I said, it will help you and your family a lot. It's a wonderful book. And I thank God for her.
Well, and we want to, and we also want to reiterate to our listening audience, if you purchase the book, all you've got to do is call me, and we'll have you come on the program and give your report on your reading of the book. So please do that. Thank you so much, and God bless.
God bless you guys, too.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. All right, ladies and gentlemen, another person talking about that book that Thomasina has written. So praise God for that. And we encourage you. We do want to encourage you, if you're a writer, a singer, a producer, a scheduler, whatever you do, if you have something that you believe would help us with our theme. Our theme is do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. That's our theme, and that's what we're about. And if you have a book that you think would help us, we would welcome you, or if it's music or whatever you'd like to do, we would welcome you to be a part of the Wiley Drake Show. And we're sorry that Crusade Radio has something else on now with us, but we're going to continue on here. If you're listening on Crusade Radio, if you're listening on Crusade Radio and would like to watch us, simply go to, let's see who this is. Well, we're going to go down off of Crusade Radio right now because there's too much noise on there anyway, and it's not really doing us any good to be on there. So we're going to continue to broadcast to you, ladies and gentlemen, here live on Ustream.com. Hello, good evening. God bless you. Welcome to the Wiley Drake Show worldwide. You're live on the air.
Hello, Pastor Drake. How are you, sir?
I'm fine. Who is this?
Dr. Mark Millar calling you from Scottsdale, Arizona.
Well, Mark Millar, thank you so much for sharing with us from Scottsdale. I have some great memories in Scottsdale, but most of which were pretty warm. But at any rate, as they always say, it was a dry heat. But 101's 101. I don't care whether it's dry or wet.
That's a fact, sir.
Well, Mark, my brother, tell us what's on your mind and what the Lord has led you to be involved with, would you please?
Certainly, I'd love to, Pastor. As you've been hearing in the news lately, there's a tremendous need to reach out to our veterans for all types of things, giving to them and serving to them and just helping them get reacclimated to society. But one thing that's really on my heart right now is to try and help the veterans with adjusting with the post-traumatic stress disorder and major depression. Yes. And trying to help beat down this suicide epidemic that they are experiencing. So the last few years of my life, I spent a lot of time developing a book that I just recently published to communicate to our veterans a breakthrough that we've discovered, that Harvard Medical School discovered, I should say, regarding a natural nutritional supplement that reduces the stress and strain and anxiety and depression and according to Harvard, reduces suicide rates by an amazing 80 to 90%. So we put together a website for your listeners, and we have an ebook there that they can take a look at, and there's all kinds of information if they'd like to go to our website and check that out and tell their families and their friends about the veteran suicide breakthrough that we are we're trying to get the word out about.
Well, Mark, as a veteran, I spent two tours of duty in Vietnam. I am a victim of post-traumatic stress syndrome. I had the unpleasure, the terrible, terrible situation when I was in Vietnam to have to kill civilians. And it has affected my life over the years. Not too many months ago, I woke up in the middle of the night reliving what I had done way back many years ago in Vietnam. And so I know a little bit about post-traumatic stress syndrome, and I do know that it is very, very devastating for our men and women in the military, and many of them are indeed committing suicide, and we certainly want to do everything we can to prevent that. And I would encourage you to give, if you would please, to our listening audience, the website that our folks can go to find out more information.
Sure. They can go to www.stopveteransuicide. So that's S-T-O-P, stop, veteransuicides.com. And there's a shortcut, and it's simply v.stopvs, Victor Sam, stopvs.com. We'll get you there quickly. And we also have a name for this mission called Operation Set Them Free. And you can go to OP, www.OP Set Them Free as well, and that'll get you to the same website.
All right. We thank you so much for giving.
Voices, they can read what's on the website, or they can download a free report. And that report will give them a PDF that they can use the links to go straight to the Harvard studies that were recently published showing the suicide rates were reduced by about 90% when patients with major depression were taking a nutritional substance called lithium. And lithium, as many of Americans know, is a pharmaceutical medicine prescribed to bipolar manic depressive patients. It's also commonly prescribed for major depression. But what most Americans don't know is that there's a non-toxic version sold over the counter in health food stores. And this product is about one-tenth the concentration of lithium per tablet, and because it's a lower dosage, it provides all the benefits of being a natural antidepressant and reduces anxiety associated with post-traumatic stress, but it does so without any of the side effects of the pharmaceutical product called lithium carbonate. So you go there to the website and check it out and pass it on to your veteran family and friends. We sure appreciate you putting out the word for us, Pastor.
Well, we certainly want to do that. And ladies and gentlemen, here's what I want to offer you. I know Mark. Actually, I know his dad, and I know of him as Doug's son. But I want to encourage you folks. As you know, I do not promote anything on this program that I have not checked out and do not verify. And I would encourage you to go to that website, go to the shortcut, and see there that book that's available. You can buy the ebook, and we encourage you to do that and get that report. Now, if you do that, ladies and gentlemen, I want to offer you something. I want to tell you, if you get that book, you get that ebook, and you read it, and you share, I want you then to contact me here at the Wiley Drake Show. And we will have you come on the show and share your experience with this Veteran Suicide Breakthrough ebook. And we encourage you to do that. Go to that website, stopvs.com, and let's help our veterans. And I want to remind all of you that are veterans, as well as those of you who honor veterans, the Congressional Prayer Conference last year in November held our first annual Honor the Veterans here in Buena Park. We're going to be doing our second annual Honor the Veterans here in Buena Park, and that will be on November the 12th. And we hope men like Mark and others will be able to be here to be speakers and to share with our veterans. And so we'll be doing that, and that will be on Monday, November the 12th on Veterans Day. And by the way, if you come to Buena Park and you're a veteran, make sure you bring your DD-214 or your ID, because on Veterans Day, the second largest amusement park in the world, Knott's Berry Farm, will allow you to come in free if you're a veteran. And you can bring in one family member, and you can even bring in other folk at a very reduced rate. So Knott's Berry Farm is honoring our veterans on November the 11th. We will be honoring them here with a special congressional prayer conference meeting here in Buena Park. Last year, we held it at Independence Hall here at Knott's Berry Farm. We're hoping to do that again this year, but even if we're not able to get into Independence Hall, we will have it here in Buena Park. So that's on November the 12th, and I'm asking other veterans and other helpers of veterans to be here. I'm asking right now Mark to pray seriously about being one of the keynote speakers and to bring materials and to be here for our Honor the Veterans. And we will be presenting to several veterans. Several veterans will be receiving some special medals. And I have the privilege to honor some very special veterans in that I am not a Native American, but the Native American nations of the United States of America, through Marshall Tall Eagle, has allowed me the privilege to present a beautiful Warrior's Medal of Valor to our veterans. And so if you would like to be the recipient, or you'd like to be the grantor of one of those medals, they're a beautiful, beautiful medal. On the front is a beautiful red, white, and blue eagle, and it says Warrior's Medal of Valor. And it then says Native American Nations of the United States of America. Now, you do not have to be a Native American to receive this Warrior's Medal of Valor. You do need to be, however, a veteran in any branch of service, but you do have to be a veteran. And if you would like to be the recipient of that on Veterans Day and come to Knott's Berry Farm free and bring your wife or your girlfriend and other family members, we would welcome you and encourage you to join us. And we're asking Mark and his dad, Doug, to be here with us on November the 12th here in Buena Park, California, just up the street from Knott's Berry Farm, where we had our first annual meeting at Independence Hall. We're hoping to do the second one there. But at any rate, we will be passing out Warrior's Medal of Valor from the Native American nations of the United States of America. Go, ladies and gentlemen, to the website, the beautiful red, white, and blue website, where you'll see Operation Set Them Free, a breakthrough for veterans and the suicide epidemic. Go there and get Mark Millar's book. Mark, thank you so much. Anything else you would share with us in reference to the book or in reference to our worldwide audience?
Well, I would just like to say that this lithium is a very controversial subject, and about half the Americans I speak to believe that lithium is a very, very toxic drug, Pastor. And the truth is, the pharmaceutical companies want Americans to believe that lithium is very dangerous. And in fact, it's an essential trace mineral. It's in the same class as sodium and potassium. It's just another electrolyte that's very powerful in the brain. It helps calm the central nervous system, and it's helping veterans with their anxiety and their sleep disorder and their insomnia. And so it just balances them out, and it does so without any side effects or any mood altering. It just makes them feel normal and well again. And so it's just a blessing from God. We just are so grateful that we found this. The veterans that are using it are raving about it. It's just a real gift for them. So just thank you for putting the word out for us, Pastor. And we'll do what we can to make some plans to get out and be with you November 12th.
Well, we certainly hope you can. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to invite all of you veterans, first of all of you veterans, to come and be here for the second annual honoring of our veterans from the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C. I will have with me again this year our new, he was the brand new co-chairman when we were there last November, and that was Dr. Clyde Rivers, who is the ambassador at large from the African nation of Burundi. And he'll be with us again. He is still with us, of course, as our co-chairman. And the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C. wants to present to some very special veterans the Warriors Medal of Valor. And if you would like to participate in awarding either your family member or a friend, you simply get in touch with me and say, Pastor, I would like to have my family member. We did one last year as well to a lady whose husband had just passed away, and we gave her the medal posthumously. And so we would encourage you to get in touch with us at the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C. Contact me here on the Wiley Drake Show. I'll give you my numbers and stuff here in a moment. But Doug Millar, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much, Doug, for sharing with us. Tell your dad we said hello, and we hope that you'll plan, if you can, to be with us on November the 12th.
Thank you again. We'll be in touch.
God bless you, my brother, and have a great day. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was Mark Millar. Mark Millar. Great work for our veterans. And we do want to remind you that on November the 12th, we will have our second annual honoring of our veterans here in Buena Park, California. The Good Park, California. And we hope and trust that God will allow us the privilege to do it again at Independence Hall. If not, we want to encourage you to come. You can go into Knott's Beer Farm absolutely free if you're a veteran. And you can also take a loved one, and you can also take other members of your family at a very reduced rate for Knott's Beer Farm. And that's quite a savings in and of itself. I was just listening a little while ago. It's about $60 to $70 now for a membership at Knott's Beer Farm. Don't know what it costs for one day, but if you're a veteran or a member of a veteran's family, you can get in free. And so we encourage you. And we will be honoring veterans here, presenting to them, to special veterans, a special medal called the Warriors Medal of Valor, presented by the Congressional Prayer Conference, but also by the Native American Nations of the United States of America. I'm going to hold that beautiful medal up and let my photographer, my cameraman, get a shot of that. And that's the medal that you will be receiving if you simply set it up. You contact me, you let me know, and we'll be glad to work that out with you. You see the camera, you see the medal on camera. May God bless you, and may God give you a great day. Now, if you would like to present one to your family member, your friend, your relative, you let me know. You simply get in touch with me, Wiley Drake. I'll give you my email as well as my phone number. My email is wileywiley@hct.net. And my phone number is 714-865-8132. In the short time we have left, I'm going to tell you how I received my Warriors Medal of Valor. I was in Washington, D.C., and I was there with Judge Moore, standing for the Ten Commandments. And a local gentleman came over to me. His name was Marshall Cerna, a veteran of Vietnam, wounded veteran of Vietnam, awarded veteran of Vietnam, came over to me and said, "Are you a veteran?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "I'd like to present to you and have you come be a part of opening the Native American Museum here in D.C. And I said, "But I'm not a Native American." He said, "That's okay." And that's where I received my medal. Good afternoon and welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. You're live on the air. Can we help you? Well, I guess that was somebody calling on another line. And that's okay. But he asked me to come and presented me with this beautiful, beautiful Warrior's Medal of Valor. He said to me, Wiley, you were a warrior in Vietnam. You deserve the Warrior's Medal. And so I was so humbled by that and so moved by that. After that ceremony and I received my medal, I said to Marshal Tall Eagle, you know, there are many other veterans that are far more worthy of this medal than me. I appreciate it, but I would like for you to come and give more medals to more veterans. And at that point, he said, I'm not able to travel that much, and so I want you to do that for me. Good afternoon and welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. You're live on the air. Go ahead. Hello? All right. Guess they didn't want to talk. But anyway, they presented me with a medal, and then they've allowed me, and now this is the Native American Nations of the United States of America. They have allowed me the privilege to be able to present to my fellow veterans this Warrior's Medal of Valor. If you'd like to participate in that, to receive it yourself, or to give it to a fellow veteran, or to give it to a family member, you simply contact me and say, I would like to be involved with the Warrior's Medal of Valor. Good afternoon. God bless you. Welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. You're live on the air. Hello? Well, I guess they don't believe me when I say they're live on the air. They just keep calling back. Ladies and gentlemen, let me say to you that if you call this show between 5 and 6 p.m., or between 9 and 10 a.m., I answer the phone, but we're live on the air. So you keep calling back, you're going to keep getting a Wiley Drake Show. So at any rate, we do thank you so much for listening today. We only have about 3 minutes left on this show. We did hang up on our show with Crusade Radio because we were not able to get on, rightly so, and we thank the Lord for Crusade Radio. Brother Mel didn't get back in time to do that for us, and we apologize for that, and we want to remind you, go to that website, and that's stopvs.com, stopvs.com, and get that free report and buy the ebook and find out what you can do. Do you know a veteran that's having struggles? Do you know a veteran that's going through literally hell here on earth? Ladies and gentlemen, I've been there. I've done that. I'm familiar with that. It's only been a few months ago that I woke up in the middle of the night in a cold sweat, reliving my killing of civilians in Vietnam. I did not want to do that, but I had to do it. It was either them or me. And so, obviously, I made the choice, and I committed what I felt like was an atrocity, and I've had to live with it ever since. Buy the ebook, buy the other ebook, Military Moms, and go and get information from Dr. Mark Millar. How to help veterans. Would you like to help a veteran? Help a veteran find out about how they cannot be victims of suicide and post-traumatic stress syndrome. And find out how you can set the veterans free. And find out how you can give a beautiful medal like this one that I received, the Warrior's Medal of Valor. Learn how you can get that for your veteran friend or your veteran family member. Call me at 714-865-8132. Or email me at WileyWiley@att.net. In the message, just say Warrior's Medal of Valor, and we will be glad to work with you, be glad to help you with that. So please contact us if you would like to do that, and may the Lord bless you. It's almost time for us to go. In just a little bit, we'll be ending our program. But before we do, I want to say to you, whatever we're talking about, it has to do with our theme: do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with Almighty God. May God bless you. We'll see you back tomorrow morning, live right here on Ustream and on Crusade Radio. May God bless you and may God give you a great evening.
Is an awesome God, he reigns from heaven above.